I really want you to interrogate and do a little bit of soul searching around your understanding or your belief about what learning is. Because, and again, you know, you see this all the time, like I see this all the time, I've lectured CTA for over a decade. And no matter what you say, like there's an embedded, no matter what you say to students, it's very hard to get over that embedded belief system that I have to know the answer. Like I have to be right. I have to know the answer. And that's important. When you talk about curiosity, when you talk about questioning, what you need to understand and what you really need to take on board and shift your thinking about is that curiosity starts with not knowing. And that's the way to do it. That doesn't, it's not wrong. It's not as though, you know, we're starting off by going, okay, so you're beginning PGDA and you must know everything now. Okay, let's go. You know, that's not it. Learning is about starting from knowing nothing and going, there's a gap. I need to learn something. Okay, I hear it. And there's a process, it's a step. And for a lot of our students, they're very binary thinkers. Yesterday, I didn't know it. Today, I must know it. You know, I attended the lecture today and now I must know it. I must get right at it. It's a very binary approach to learning. So I really would encourage, because a lot of the challenge and a lot of that discomfort comes from the expectation that I'm supposed to know this stuff like that. There's a lot of, I find, you know, students are tearing themselves up because they're going, Yvonne, I can't pass PGDA. I won't be able to do it. I'm struggling with the stuff because I don't know the stuff so quickly, or I struggle with the stuff. That's okay. And that's expected. That's the right thing.
We've got to be kind to ourselves. Not in the sense that you can make excuses for being lazy, but be kind to yourself in terms of, if you don't get it first time, well, to be honest, neither did I. To be honest, neither did the other lecturers, none of the other students. The difference, if you really want to look at it, the difference between the student who comes top of the class and the student who kind of drops out and fails and gets poor marks is kind of how they are able to deal with the struggles.
Yes, discomfort.
I promise you, the guy at the top of the class has as many struggles as the guy at the bottom of the class. The difference is the guy who comes top of the class says, geez, man, that was a tough struggle. Gets up again and tries it again. Gets up and tries again and pushes and pushes. I always say, like, there were times when I studied towards being a CA where I woke up in the morning and I thought, this is too hard. I can't do it. I'm not clever enough. I'm grateful that I am where I am, but I've never assumed that I was kind of perfect or knew all the answers. I never felt like that. I've always kind of felt like I'm this insecure little boy. And people need to know that. Like,
yes, so true.
Everyone feels, I think, those insecurities and that lack of knowing. No one's got it figured out. Everyone's just learning. Everyone's figuring it out as we go. But just keep going. Keep curious. Keep going. Keep pushing. Yeah. And these things have a way of sorting themselves out if you keep following that path.
And calm down. Calm down. If you don't know it after the first lecture, it doesn't mean anything, because it's so quick to go, oh, I don't know that I failed test one or whatever the case is. And so therefore it means that I'm going to fail PGDA. I'm going to fail. I'm never going to qualify. Da, da, da. It doesn't mean anything. What it means is that you need to interrogate your understanding and go back and go, okay, do I need to hear that again? Do I need to listen to it? Do I need to ask a question? Do I need to and let me move. It's not a switch. Learning is not a switch. If it is a switch, you're doing the wrong thing. You know, if it's as simple as going, didn't know it yesterday, know it's capable, 100% able to do it, everything's fine, then like something's a little bit off, because that's not how learning actually works.